Now it's a time to take up section 3, question number 1. Three lines are given by r equals lambda I cap, r equals mu I plus j cap, and r equals nu I plus j plus k cap. Let the lines cut the plane x plus y plus z equals 1 at 3 points A, B, and C. If the area of the triangle ABC is delta, you have to find the value of 6 delta whole square. So there are three lines given to you in this question. Say for example like this 1, 2 and 3. Right? A plane is cutting these three lines at 3 points. Let's consider plane is cutting this line here A, B and C. Now question says when these three points are joined, then find the area of this triangle. So how to do it? Simple. Just consider a point on this line. What is that? Lambda. A point on this line, mu comma mu. A point on this line, nu comma nu comma nu. That's clear. So on the first line, there is a point you consider lambda comma 0 comma 0. On the second one, you can say it is mu comma 0. On the third one, nu comma nu comma nu. Right? Since we are talking about the intersection of planes, so put this point in plane to get lambda, mu and nu. So let's start this question. When you put point A in plane, you will get lambda, from B mu and from C nu. From A you get simply lambda plus 0 plus 0 is equal to 1. So lambda is 1, therefore point A is 1, 0, 0. Right? From point B, you get mu plus mu is equal to 1. That means the value for mu is half. So point B is obtained as half, comma half, comma 0. Similarly, from C, you get mu plus nu plus nu is equal to 1. So from here C is 1 by 3, 1 by 3 and 1 by 3. So you got points A, B and C. Now you are looking for area of the triangle ABC. So area of triangle ABC is equal to half modulus of say AB cross AC. Right? So this is half modulus of, when you talk about AB vector, this is simply half minus 1, that is minus half I cap plus half J cap. Correct? Multiplied with the AC vector, so 1 by 3 minus 1. So this gives you minus 2 by 3 I cap plus 1 by 3 J cap plus 1 by 3 K cap. So this is AB cross AC vector. Just find out this part to simplify to get the final result with you. This is half multiplied with half multiplied with 1 by 3. Just take half and 1 by 3 common, and then modulus of determinant formed by I, J, K, right? Minus 1, 1, 0, and the next is minus 2, 1, 1. I'm sure this point is clear. So this gives you 1 by 12 multiplied with modulus of I multiplied with 1 minus J multiplied with minus 1, so it becomes plus 1, and then K times you have minus 1 plus 2, that is plus 1. So here plus K, giving you root 3 by 12 as the required area. Now let's see what the question is asking for. Question is asking for whole square of 6 delta. So this is equal to delta. From here we have 6 delta whole square is equal to simply root 3 by 2 whole square, root 3 by 2 whole square, or 0.75. So the correct answer for this question is 0.75. So let's highlight this one as our final result. So I'm sure this is clear. Let's take up the next question. Question number 2 says, if I equals 2 upon pi integral minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4 dx upon this term, we have to talk about 27 I square. I equals, let's write down the integral, 2 by pi minus pi by 4, 2 pi by 4 dx divided by, so integral is this one, when you apply a plus b minus x property, you will see a plus b is simply 0. So it becomes denominator as 1 plus e to the power minus sin x multiplied with 2 minus cos 2x, right? This can further be rewritten as 2 upon pi multiplied with minus pi by 4 to pi by 4. You can write it as 1 upon e to the power sin x, or simplifying it is e to the power sin x dx divided by 1 plus e to the power sin x multiplied with 2 minus cos 2x. Say this is equation number 2 and the given one is equation number 1. Just add 1 and 2. Adding 1 and 2, we get 2i is equal to 2 upon pi integral minus pi by 4 to pi by 4 dx divided by 2 minus cos 2x. So 2 is cancelled, and here you can see this term 1 upon 2 minus cos 2x is even function. So you can write twice of 0 to pi by 4. So finally we have I is equal to 2 upon pi integral 0 to pi by 4. Now this cos 2x can be changed to either sine or cos or directly to tan as well. So here you can write, after taking LCM, sec square x dx divided by 2 times 1 plus tan square x minus 1 minus tan square x. I'm sure this part is clear how we are writing it. We have simply changed cos 2x into tan x term. So this is equal to 2 by pi integral 0 to pi by 4 sec square x dx divided by 1 plus 3 tan square x. If I plan tan x as t, I will get sec square x dx as dt. If I take 3 common, I can write it as 2 by 3 pi, right? We have sec square x dx upon 1 by 3 plus tan square x, meaning root 3 tan inverse root 3 tan x 0 to pi by 4, right? Just substitute x as pi by 4, you find tan inverse root 3, meaning pi by 3 only. So result is 2 upon root 3 pi into pi by 3 is equal to 2 upon 3 root 3. So this is I. Now what the question is asking for? Question is asking for 27i square. So let's write down 27i square. Therefore, 27i square is 27 multiplied with 4 by 27, or the result is 4. So our correct answer over here is 4. So I'm sure this question is also clear to you how we get the result as 4. Let's move on to the third question. Let's take question number 3. Let the point B be the reflection of point A, which is 2, 3, with respect to the line 8x minus 6y minus 23 equals 0. Let gamma A and gamma B be circles of radii 2 and 1 respectively, with centers A and B. Let T be the common tangent of circle gamma A and gamma B, such that both the circles are on the same side of T. That's clear, it's not about the transversal, it's like both are on the same side. If C is the point of intersection of T and the line passing through A and B, then the length of line segment AC is. Let's plan what the question is talking about. First, let's draw two circles, one of the smaller radius, other of the bigger radius. One is radius 1 and other is radius 2. Next, we draw a tangent line like this, correct? Next, we draw a line which is joining their centers like this and intersecting with this given line here. We can also draw the second line. We can draw here the radii, the first circle and the second circle. I am sure these points are clear. Okay, let's see what the points are given to me. It is given this is point A, that is 2, 3, correct. Now reflection is B, right. When it is given that radius is 2 and 1 for circles with center at A and B respectively, let T be the common tangent of these two circles and C is the point of intersection of tangent and this line. Question is, find the length of AC, right? This is 1, this is 2. Clearly, if I say this angle is theta, so I can plan this question as sine theta is equal to this length upon this length, right? Let's mark these one as M and N. So we can write here AM by AC is equal to BN by BC. Can we find this length? Yes. How we can find this length? First, we need the another line given to us, this one, right? B is the reflection of A, meaning if you consider this point as R, then BR equals AR. So first you need to find the length of perpendicular from center A to the given line. So AR is modulus of, equation of line is 8x minus 6y minus 23. So it becomes 16 minus 18 minus 23 upon root of 64 plus 36, that is simply 10. So this gives you equal to, you can see from here, minus 2 minus 23, that is finally result is 5/2. So this length is 5/2. So this is also 5/2, right? Now moving back to the sine theta part, is equal to AM, meaning 2, upon AC, the required length, equals 1 divided by BC, BC meaning AC minus 5. I am sure this point is clear. Just cross multiply the 2 to get the value for AC. So here we see 2AC minus 10 is equal to AC, or length AC is equal to 10. So the correct answer we obtain for this question is simply AC is equal to 10. Let's see what the question was talking about. Just find the value AC. So mention here 10 and this is our final result. Let's move on to the next question. Let's take the next question, that is fourth. Let AP, A and D denote the set of all the terms of an infinite AP with the first term A and common difference D, right? Now, if AP 1, 3, AP 2, 5, AP 3, 7, the intersection of these three is AP A, D, then A plus D equals. So we have to first find that what this new AP is actually. So let's start this question. Let's say the first one, AP 1, it would be 1, 4, 7, 10 and so on. What is the common difference here? Here common difference is 3. AP 2, it is like 2, 7, 12, 17 and so on. Here common difference is 5. And AP 3 is simply 3, 10, 17 and so on. Here common difference is 7. Now when you talk about the common part, the intersection, we know that we have to find the first term and the common difference will simply be LCM of the two common differences. If you talk about condition 1, condition 2, and AP 3. Now from 1 and 2 we can find the intersection part as AP 1 intersection AP 2. This will simply be, you can see 7 is the first term, common one, and 15 is the common difference. So it would be 7, then it becomes 22, then adding 15 it is 37, then 52 and so on. Right? Now, from 2 and 3, if you plan AP2 and AP3, from AP2 intersection AP3, we can see here the first common term is 17 and the common difference is 35. So, it is 17 plus 35, that is 52, plus 35, that is 87, and so on, right? If you look at AP1 intersection AP2 intersection AP3. So, clearly 52 is the first common term. And what is the common difference? Common difference will be simply LCM of the common differences of the two. From this one, the common difference was 15 and from here it was 35. So, LCM is 105. So, LCM is 105. So, yes, we can write here AP is like 52 comma. What is the next term? Next term is 52 plus 105, that is 157, and so on. Now, what the question is talking about? Therefore, A plus D is 157. This would be our final result for this question. So, I'm sure this point is clear how we are solving it. Let's write down this one here as 157, our final result. Let's move on to the next one. Now, taking the question number 5 of section 3, let S be the sample space of all 3 by 3 matrices with entries from the set 0 and 1. Let the events E1 and E2 be given by E1 equals A such that determinant A is 0. Event 2 is A such that sample space is saying sum of entries of A is 7. If a matrix is chosen at random from S, then the conditional probability P even by E2, that is probability that the determinant A is 0 given that it has been chosen from a set such that sum of elements of A is 7 is. So, let's just start this question. In order to form E2, we are looking that sum of entries is 7. Since we have 0 and 1 as entries only, so how we can get the sum as 7? Yes, let's draw the determinant first. There are 9 entries. So, when you talk about E2, sum is 7, meaning 7 elements are 1 and 2 are zeros. How we can get it? Simply, we can say number of elements in E2 is equal to 9C2. Just select 2 cells where you are going to put zeros. At rest positions, you will place 1. So, this is equal to 36. This is clear. Next. For E1, you are saying that determinant of A is 0, but we are looking for conditional probability E1 by E2. So, we can find directly E1 intersection E2, that is in those cases of E2 where determinant A is 0. And when you can see 0? Simply, when you say that 2 zeros are there in the same row or same column, like 100 or 100. In that case, what will happen? 100, 111, 111. Row 2 and row 3 are identical. Determinant's value is 0. So, value will be 0 when these 2 zeros are in same column or in same row. That's clear. How we can get it? Simply, we can get it if we are talking about row, right? So, you can say this would be simply 3C1 into 3C2 into 2. What I have done? I have simply said 3C1, meaning from the 3 rows, select 1 row. Then 3C2, from this 1 row, select 2 entries where you are going to put zeros. Or you talk about columns, so just multiply with 2. So, this is equal to 18. So, what is the required probability here? Therefore, probability E1 by E2 is equal to 18 by 36 or is equal to 0.5. So, finally, we obtain correct answer as 0.5. Let's write down this term as 0.5, our correct answer for this question. So, I'm sure this question is also clear from probability. Let's move on to the next question. So moving on to question number 6 of section 3, that is the last question of this paper 1 of JEE Advanced 2019. Let omega not equal to 1 be a cube root of unity. That means omega is the complex cube root of unity. Then the minimum of the set mod a plus b omega plus c omega square whole square, where a, b, c distinct non-zero integers equals. Let's try this question. Mod a plus b omega plus c omega square whole square is equal to a plus b omega plus c omega square multiplied with its conjugate, meaning a plus b omega square, because conjugate of omega is omega square, plus c omega equals a square plus b square plus c square. Why? Because b square omega cube, c square omega cube, that means simply b square and c square, minus ab omega square plus ab omega, meaning ab times omega plus omega square, so it becomes minus ab. Similarly, minus bc and minus ca. This can be rewritten as half of a minus b whole square plus b minus c whole square plus c minus a whole square, right? Now when you look at this term, a, b, c are distinct, clearly given to us. So the minimum value, meaning you can plan for the minimum difference between the two consecutive terms as 1, right? So here you plan the difference as 1, here you plan the difference as 1, here you plan the difference as 2, meaning it becomes half of 1 plus 1 plus 4, or this is equal to 3. So let's write down the correct answer for this question, as the value required is simply 3. So I'm sure this question is also clear. So this was 6, that is the last question of this section, as well as this paper 1 of JEE Advanced 2019. Thank you for watching the videos.